Hi, in this video we'll be taking a look at how to train and use triggers in Doubler 2. Triggers in Doubler allow you to control samples, drum racks or plugins in your DAW by making percussive input sounds such as beatboxing, clicking or clapping. To do this, you need to teach Doubler the input sounds you want to use and which MIDI note will be assigned to that sound. So once you've got all your triggers trained, when Doubler hears that input sound, it will send out that associated MIDI note. So let's take a look at how to train these triggers in Doubler 2. To add our first trigger, we can hit the plus button on the left-hand side here, and that'll then take us to the Train tab. You'll see the first trigger on the left labelled Bass Drum 1, and it's assigned to the MIDI note C1 at the bottom here. Now, C1 is labelled as a Bass Drum 1, as in most drum racks or plugins, a C1 is a kick, but this might not always be the case depending on the plugin or sample you're using. So you can change what MIDI note the trigger applies to on the note drop-down menu here, or you can also do that via the suggested MIDI notes at the bottom. But for this, we'll just leave it at C1. So once you've selected the desired MIDI output, it's time to teach Doubler the sound you want to use to activate that trigger. It's really important to bear in mind that longer sounds, such as boom, ka, are not going to result in a very accurate output, and we want to pick short, sharp, and percussive sounds. So for this kick drum, I'm going to use a sound. So once I've landed on a sound that I want to use, I'm going to hit record takes, and then repeat that sound up to 12 times to light up all these takes. It's also important to be consistent as possible when recording these takes so Doubler has properly learnt that sound you want to use. So I'm going to hit record takes and then repeat that sound. If you're not happy with the sounds you've recorded, or you record an example by accident, you can hit clear all takes to clear the bank and start again. Each trigger is also velocity sensitive, meaning you can record quieter, softer percussion or loud, high velocity percussion depending on your input. Sometimes you might not want that behaviour, so you can turn off velocity response via this switch here, and this will ensure that Doubler always triggers that sample at full velocity. At the top, you can also rename your trigger, and a quick tip here is that if you struggle to remember which sound you use for each trigger, you can name it something to remind you of that allocated sound. So as we trained up sound for this kick, I'm going to name this P kick. So I can now repeat this process and add up to 8 triggers for this profile. So I'm just going to add a couple more now. If I hit this plus button, our second trigger will add, and it's now allocated to a D1, which is an acoustic snare. So I'm going to hit record takes, and again, remembering to choose a short and sharp sound. So for this, I'm going to use a t kind of sound. I'm going to add another one here. So this is a closed hi-hat. Again, short and sharp, I'm going to use a t sound. I'm going to clear takes because I accidentally triggered that. And then let's add one more, which is a hand clap. So I'm going to use a kind of sound for this. So now that's our triggers trained, I can head back to the play tab and I'll see all the triggers we trained here available to use. You'll also notice in the top left the level slider here, and this controls how sensitive the triggers are to your input. So the higher the level, the more it will be sensitive to velocity changes and nuanced sounds, but this can make it easier to accidentally trigger the wrong sample. But the lower the sensitivity, the more consistent the triggers will be in terms of velocity, but the harder it will be to do quick, complex beats. But for most normal use cases, we recommend keeping it at its default level. So now that we've got our trigger set up, we can use these to record MIDI information into our DAW. So I've just got Logic set up here with a drum machine. If I hit record, I can record in on MIDI. So that's how to set up triggers in Doubler 2. If you want to find out more, including how to set up based on your specific DAW, make sure to check out our Learn Doubler page.